In this problem, we're given 6 exponential functions. 3 of them are exponential growth, and 3 of them are exponential decay. For each function, we want to find the initial value and also the growth or decay rate as a percentage. To begin, let's identify which functions are exponential growth and which are exponential decay. For exponential growth in this form here, the base b is called the growth factor, which is equal to 1 plus r, where r is the growth rate as a decimal. So because b is equal to 1 plus r, the base is always greater than 1, and therefore we have an increasing function. For exponential decay, the base b is called the decay factor, which is equal to 1 minus r, where r is the decay rate as a decimal. So because we're subtracting r here, for exponential decay, the base is always less than 1, and therefore we have a decreasing function. So looking at our 6 functions, notice how here the base is 1.2, which is greater than 1, so this would be exponential growth. Next we have a base of 0.86, which is less than 1, this would be exponential decay. Next we have a base of 0.4, this is also exponential decay. Next we have a base of 1.38, which is greater than 1, so this would be exponential growth. Next we have a base of 3, which is greater than 1, this is exponential growth. And finally we have a base of 0.92, so we have exponential decay. Notice in all these exponential functions, a is the initial amount or initial value, which we can easily identify. So for this first function, notice how the initial value, initial amount, would be 310. And now for the growth rate, we can find it using the equation b equals 1 plus r, since you know b is equal to 1.2. We can probably determine this value mentally, but let's go ahead and show some work on the next slide. Again, for exponential growth, we know that the base b, or the growth factor, is equal to 1 plus r, where for our first equation, b is equal to 1.2. So we'd have 1.2 equals 1 plus r, which again, we can probably tell r must be 0.2, or we can subtract 1 on both sides, giving us r equals 0.2. So this is the decimal form of the growth rate, but we want this as a percentage, not as a decimal. So to convert a decimal to a percentage, we multiply by 100 and add a percent sign, which is equivalent to moving the decimal point to the right 2 places, giving us 20%. So for our first equation, we have a growth rate of 20%. Our next function is exponential decay. The initial amount or initial value is still 15, and now we'll show some work to find the decay rate. For exponential decay, the base b of the decay factor is equal to 1 minus r, where b is equal to 0.86. So we have 0.86 equals 1 minus r. Again, we probably can solve this mentally and recognize that r is equal to 0.14. But if not, we can always solve this as an equation, subtract 1 on both sides. This would give us negative r equals negative 0.14 divided by negative 1. And we have r equals 0.14. But this is the decimal form, and we want the percent. So 0.14 times 100 would give us 14 at the percent sign. So we have a decay rate of 14%. Next we have another exponential decay function where the decay factor is 0.4. So we'd have 0.4 must equal 1 minus r. Again, we probably recognize that r is going to be 0.6 or 60%. But if we don't, we can show the work. Negative r equals negative 0.6 divided by negative 1. We have r equals 0.6, which would be 0.6 times 100 as a percentage. That'd be 60%. Notice how this is the same as moving the decimal point to the right 2 places. So our decay rate as a percentage is 60%. And the initial value or initial amount is 112. Our next function is exponential growth, where the initial value is 310. So if b, or the growth factor, is 1.38, we should be able to recognize that r would be 0.38, or 38%. But again, I'll go ahead and show the work. We would have 1.38 equals 1 plus r, subtracting 1 on both sides, gives us 0.38 equals r. 0.38 times 100 would be 38, or 38%. We have another exponential growth function here. Well, the initial value is 528. And let's go ahead and show some work for the growth rate. Notice how if the growth factor, or the base, is 3, we'd have 3 equals 1 plus r. Subtracting 1 on both sides, we have r equals 2. So the growth rate as a decimal is 2. Well, 2 times 100 is equal to 200, or 200%, which is our growth rate as a percentage. Our last function is exponential decay, with an initial value of 90. And the decay factor, or the base b, is equal to 0.92. So if we recognize the decay rate is going to be 0.08, or 8%, that's perfect. If not, we can show the work, where we'd have b equals 0.92 equals 1 minus r, subtract 1 on both sides. Negative r equals negative 0.08, and divide by negative 1. So we have r equals 0.08 as a decimal, as a percentage. Multiply by 100, this would give us 8%. So our decay rate equals 8%. I hope you found this helpful.